Interview Martin Cris, segment 1, première.
Half a year ago, I made a video where I asked for a project manager and I found one. Chris, welcome
hey.
To the project.
Thank you.
You have heard me talk about Chris a lot and we have prepared a very special video for you. Today we're going to talk about the PBS system that Chris has blessed me with and blessed the Marble Machine project with. By the end of the video, we will give you some downloadable templates and stuff, and we will try to show you first how we are using it.
Yes.
To inspire you to maybe try using it yourself. But before we go into that, I just want to introduce Chris to you. You are actually a real engineer, right?
I guess you can say so. I worked in the automotive industry and the energy industry as well, and I've worked to manage some pretty complex projects, and that's very useful in your case.
In my form where I was asking for the project manager, my questions were super long and your answers was one word. Yes. Do you think that my question? And Chris was like, absolutely not. And I was like, whoa, this person is efficient. So it was like efficient answer on my non-efficient questions.
I tried to answer with what I thought you needed. I think you needed someone to make things simple for you.
Yeah, you have really done that, and that's partly why I want to show you, the viewers, what a PBS system can do for you. I remember when you came here, you were so surprised about how complex this machine actually is.
I was expecting some level of complexity because I had been watching your videos for some time, and I knew that there were many parts and it was many different materials. So I was expecting some complexity, but when I came into the project and I had access to the full 3D model, and not only what you did, but what you had in mind, and I totally understood what you were struggling with. Fortunately, I had in my toolbox some stuff, and the PBS is one of them, that helps to deal with such complexity by breaking down
a
lot of things into some manageable subsystems, sub-assemblies.
Yeah, I think that's a tip for everyone. I love that. If you're going to walk 1,000 steps, you just have to walk one step at a time. You can't walk 1,000 steps. So we break it down. And you can do it in an absurdly small thing. If you want to clean your room, like, okay, first, clean your desk. And that's actually what we did. So, Chris, PBS product breakdown structure, what is it?
What is it? Okay, so I would say that most people are comfortable with the BOM, the bill of materials.
Bill of material is actually all the things you need to build something. So if I want to build this cup, I need clay, I need paint, and I need lacquer.
A bill of material is not enough for a project as complex as yours. You need to have a hierarchy of the things in your machine. The product breakdown system is basically the list of everything.
Yeah.
Both the assemblies and the parts. Your complexity is the machine. Some people, their complexity is the work that they should do. So in this case, it's a work breakdown system, describing the actions you need to do.
WBS.
WBS, work breakdown system. And on some very complex project, you basically need to do both. In our case, we had a complex machine to describe, so we used a PBS.
Okay, so now you have learned BOM, bill of material, WBS, work
breakdown
system, PBS, product breakdown structure.
I said that we had the structure of the machine, like a tree. So on top of this tree, we have this marble machine X, okay? And you see that there is a PBS number here, and this one is very simple. It's 000-000. The first three digits describe in what assembly we are. So the first higher digit is the top level assembly.
So the five first assemblies we have on the Marble Machine X is 100 is the base, 200 is the mid section with the programming wheel, 300 is the top section with the levers and the marble divider, 400 is all the instruments, and 500 is the sides. And So as soon as we see a number for a part, I can look at the first number and I know this part belongs to the top section.
True. Yeah, that's it. So we break it down into main assemblies. So that's the second digit.
So now when we talk to each other in the team, we don't say, oh, you know that little thing that sits down there in the machine. We say, I'm done with 1J0001. Can you check if the material is correct? Mm. And then I get a reply from Marius or Alex. It looks good. There's something, it's about what we talked about in the beginning, breaking down the Mount Everest. And these numbers is actually so lovely to have.
If a part breaks down during a tour, for instance, you can just call in your support team and ask for 3J0012.
Yeah.
And then they know straight away what they need, if they can print it, if they can CNC machine it.
Yeah.
They will do it and send it, and it will be the right part.
Yes.
We have sub-assemblies. So it's even smaller. By using the first three digits, we only describe the assembly structures, the tree. So now we need to add the parts described by the last three digits. Assemblies are always triple zeros, but as soon as you've got a number with a digit, it means that it's a part.
Yeah.
So that's how the PBS number works. First level here, marble machine X, 000000. The base, as you said, is 100. And then we go down to the base frame, so 110. And then front, back, they all have part number on it.
In this system, we can see what type of a part is, if it's a design part, if it's an assembly, or if it's a hardware part. And then we can see how we're building the part, if we're cutting it from plywood CNC, DXF cut, 3D print, off the shelf, if we buy a screw or something, or if it's manual machining. How many of the parts we need, CAD issue, this was because I did a lot of bad CADing, so sometimes I had to clean up things and then I mark it with clean. And then here, super important, in what state a part is. Basically, a part starts with being not designed, and then it's design in progress, and then it's designed, and then it is ready to order, and then it goes to our procurement manager, Alex. When he's ordered it, he puts it as O, ordered. When I received it, I put it as R, received. When I have assembled it, I put it as A. And when I have changed my mind and make a new design, I put it as X, deprecated.
But that never happens. That never happens. The project owner automatically changes. Yeah. So depending on what status the part is, so the part is ready to order. So Alex sees that, he can filter this sheet via his name. And then he sees all the parts that he can order. And when he's done his part, he can change the status so you know that it's on its way.
Yeah.
The fusion model has the same names.
So for example, the last pipe of the marble divider, and it's here. If I click it, we can find it here. And you can see that inside fusion, this pipe has the same part number. So it's really easy to find it. So now we hope that you understand the PBS number, and I thought the PBS was just a list, but it's so much more than that. You have connected analytics to this list.
Yes.
So how does that work?
Since we had this data available to us, now we could make sense of it and to gather some global information about this. This first area is describing assemblies and parts. These 637 are the unique designs that you and the other guys had to CAD, basically. So that's a lot.
Yeah.
In total, that makes the machine being 6,000 to 7,000 parts. This is the summary of the stages of the machine. So you see how many not designed parts and assemblies we have.
So this automatically updates when I fill in the PBS.
Yes. Yeah. If you add a unique design, this will increase by one count.
Ah. That's so cool.
Okay. Yeah. And when you change the status, this automatically updates this sheet. Even if it's not visible to the audience, there was a huge work done to move the design from this area to the ordered and received.
Yeah.
So it's not visible because the parts are not on the machine, but there are so much going in the pipe now.
And what is this progress that looks very interesting?
Progress is making sense of the work that we have to do. If you started with a blank sheet, your progress would be 0%.
Yeah.
Okay. So now we are at 83%. A huge job has been done over the last 2 months.
And here you have a real figure on my procrastination problem, because the instrument is the most near and dear section of the machine to me. So I couldn't just not make myself make the decision. So I've been procrastinating making decisions on the instrument section. And that's why that one is so far behind. So you can see that we really have the most work left to do on the instruments. Mm. But the cool thing with this whole analytics that has helped me so much is that it has been like a motivating thing. So when I go into the PBS and I change a part from that I have it received and that is assembled on the machine, I can go in here and check 83.66 moves to 83.67. Chris has made a blank version of our PBS, the custom built PBS for the Marble Machine X project. You can fill in anything with your project, the analytics will work the same. You told me there's even companies selling this service, but I just want to share it with you because it helped me so much and I think potentially it could help. Let us know what you used it for. We would be super interested to hear if you actually found a use for it. So, in this blank template, there will be a lot of spreadsheet voodoo. And I wanted to ask you, Chris, if you could try to explain three voodoo functions.
Out of the functions that we use, people can navigate in the cells and have a look for themselves. But one of the functions that you will see used is the nested if functions. So whenever you want to check for many conditions at the same time, you can do that. So this is a bit scary.
Yes.
Okay. But if you just take it step by step, it makes sense. You ask the spreadsheet to check for something. And in this case, we check if the part is design in progress. Okay. We say, okay, whenever the design is in progress, Marius is in charge of it.
Okay, makes sense.
Okay, so this, the first part is what it checks for. The second part is what happens if the check is true. And if the check is false, you see another if. So that's the reason why we call it nested. And then if it's false, it will check for something else. So is the part a design part?
So if people want to learn this, they can search for nested if.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, okay. How can we work with one sheet from the data in another one? So this is with the function import range. To help us make our sheets lighter and more efficient, it was a huge deal. So just by doing that and by giving the unique identifier from the file you refer to, you can import a range of cells. And then you can happily work with whatever data is imported. The last function we want to show you is the basic count function. So you check for one value or one state of a cell, and depending on that, it will count how many of the cells have this value. Okay? There is also the count A. That you can use, so you can Google to see the difference. But this basically helps you count cases of data in a column. Okay, so it's very basic stuff, but that's been used a lot and used to make sense of the data we have.
If I understood it correctly, every serious engineering project has a PBS system or some sort.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You need to have that. Hmm.
So in a way, this was a natural evolution. True. Of this DIY making project. Now the project is being taken as seriously as it has to be taken thanks to the PBS system, and it has really changed my life. And so I was thinking, like, how can I improve other parts of my life, because that was so great. So I've actually started making breakfast using a PBS structure.
Thank you.
So, Chris, when is the Marble Machine X going to be finished?
That's the hardest question.
But you have all these analytics, you should know.
With the new design team that we are onboarding as we speak, yeah. First assembly is really testing the functionality of the machine. I believe we can do that before the end of the year. It will probably not as complete as we would hope for, but I think it would give us a pretty good idea about how the machine works and even, I mean, testing some bit of a song.
So in your master plan that you made for the project, right now we are in the phase of first assembly obsession. We only think about getting the first assembly. This assembly does not have to, it should not be perfect. So this first assembly by the end of this year, and then we start a troubleshooting phase, and then maybe I can mix also composing music during the troubleshooting phase. And who knows how long time that will take. Big thanks, Chris, because you have meant so much to the project.
My
also
pleasure.
To me personally, because you're a humanist. I'm so happy that we have this match, and you have the engineering understanding and you have the understanding of how to work efficiently, but you also have the respect for sometimes I want to spend more time on a part just to make it more beautiful. You also respect the artistic side of the project, which maybe from an engineering point of view is actually just extra cost. That's actually amazing. And yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you to have me on board.
I'm hearing a applause from the audience right now because they have seen me struggle with this. And now when they see that you are here structuring things, I hear them shouting. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something about PBS system. And see you on the next Wintergatan Wednesday.
Bye.
Bye.